Few heads to another review. About time, back in action. That's right. And today, I am here with my thoughts on Amouage Memoir Man. Amanda will be in later, but first, I'm going to give you my thoughts. And this video is dedicated to a longtime subscriber of mine, Seven Strangelove. That's right. What's going on, buddy? Last week, I got to talking with him, and I asked him, I was like, is there anything you want to see me do a video on? And he's like, yeah, I'd really love to get your thoughts on Memoir Man, because I've been thinking about that fragrance. So I said, let's do it. Here we are. Amanda and I are going to let you know, brother. So, my thoughts on Memoir Man. This fragrance starts off being an aggressive, herbal, green, minty fragrance. You've got basil in here, you've got wormwood, aka absinthe, giving you a very camphorous, green, woody type of scent with a nuance of anise flowing through it. And underneath that, you've got this balsamic quality, a mixture of sandalwood and vanilla, with a touch of incense flowing through there. Now, a lot of people talk about tobacco in here. I don't really pick up on a lot of tobacco myself. A lot of people talk about smoke. I don't really get a big smoky vibe out of this fragrance as well. I get a touch of it as this dries down. A little touch of smoke from the guaiac wood starts to come out. But just a little. Not very much at all. And as this dries down, I lose that aggressive green herbal quality at the top. She tames down, the edges smoothen out. And it does. This fragrance goes from a very edgy, sharp fragrance to a very velvety, smooth fragrance when that top part disappears and that sandalwood vanilla comes out. It does get very smooth, very gentle, very soft. And it pretty much remains that way for the most of the time this is on my skin. Now there's leather listed in here as well. I don't know, maybe a suede bringing in that that smooth character, but I don't get a big leather kick out of this fragrance as well. And there's rose listed. I personally don't get a lot of rose in here either. Basically what I get is just that gentle sandalwood vanilla combo with incense flowing through it. Because as that green herbal top starts to dissipate, the incense becomes more dominant with that balmy base. As far as projection, this one doesn't really jump off the skin for me. It sits closer to the skin. Not going to knock it for that. Longevity, 10 plus hours. So very solid on my skin. So you got to appreciate that. My overall thought on this fragrance, though, I've had this for 2 or 3 years now, and I've worn it numerous times. And every single time that I wear it, it's just kind of meh. I don't know. It just doesn't grab me at all. Just meh. I mean, it's okay. But I mean, okay, for $290, you got to do a lot better than that for me. But there is crazy love for this fragrance out there. Lots of people absolutely adore this stuff. And if you look on Fragrantica, I'll show now, you can see there's lots of love for this fragrance out there. But for me, it just doesn't do it. For me, I would rate this fragrance on a personal level 3 out of 5 stars. And being that it's meh, and it's $290, that takes it down to a 2. This is something for me that's forgettable. After today, I'm probably never ever going to wear it again. I'm never really going to ever talk about it again. It just doesn't do it for me. So, Seven Strangelove, take that as you will. This is something I would definitely sample first. Because, you know, if you're out there and you're a person that likes to blind buy and you're reading all of these awesome comments and awesome reviews of Memoir Man and you're like, damn, that is gotta be the ticket. That's gotta be the stuff. And then you get it. And it works for you like it does for my taste. And you go, what the hell? This sucks. It doesn't really suck, but it's just meh. Like I said, you know, you're gonna be awfully disappointed with that blind buy. So, those are my thoughts. Let's find out what the lovely Amanda thinks about it.
All right, Seven Strange Love, it's time to get a lady's opinion. Yep. What will Amanda have to say about Memoir Man?
Why am I whispering? I don't know.
I don't know, just because it sounds intriguing.
I know. Memoir Man. Yeah. It's cool. It's got a cool name. Cool premise. You know, the bottle's cool, but I don't know. Here. Okay. All right.
Not too bad, but I kind of have that, I don't know, like that vetiver grassy smell.
Yeah.
The bat. Yeah. Let me smell it again. Yeah, incense-y. It's okay. I mean, it's all right. I mean, it's, I don't know. Not to put down like all the other fragrances that you have of like that oud and spice and vetiver type of smell.
Yeah.
It's yeah, like you say, meh. It's okay, but
like if we were at a store, and
I wouldn't pick it.
And I was looking at this, and I was like, it's $290. You know, and you smelled it. Does that smell like $290? Like some fragrances smell like money. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like that smells like it's worth $290.
Yeah.
Is that like, does that like smell like money to you?
No.
No?
No, I know what money smells.
Ha! Money's dirty!
No. No, you know? I wouldn't say that'd be. I wouldn't call it like $300. I mean, I'd say it'd be like, I don't know, maybe $125.
It's kind of got a little bit of an old school like barbershop feel in there as well. Old school masculine kind of green fougere quality in there.
Yeah.
I mean, mixed with that incense. I can see why people would like this. I mean, there's a lot going on, so it is kind of cool, you know, with the incense and the mint and the wormwood and the, you know, the sandalwood and vanilla, but the overall composition just, it doesn't make me go, damn, you know, like Jubilation 25.
Yeah, it's like it's missing something.
It's just kind of like this should be, I don't know, maybe $100 a bottle.
Yeah.
$150 maybe. $290, I mean, with a name like Amouage, come on man, you gotta be a lot more impressive than that, I think anyway.
Right.
So, alright.
That's my thoughts.
That's it. Hope.
It's good. But not $290 worth.
Yeah.
Maybe a $30 sample, like, you know, it'd be alright.
Decant it,
yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
So that's it. Hope you enjoyed Seven Strange Love, and good to be back, and we'll see you guys soon.
Bye.